Karyotsubo and welcome everybody to Let's Play Risen. So, what is this game all about? Well, to keep it short, this is the spiritual successor to the Gothic franchise, which I played the first two games and currently still sort of streaming the third game. Well, because the developers, Piranha Bytes, lost the Gothic license to their publisher Joe Wood, who proceeded to run the franchise into the ground with a really awful add-on outsourced to an Indian development team. What a great idea that was, and also cranking out another crappy sequel. But yes, so Piranha Bytes had to move on and created a new franchise, Risen, which has up to this point already 3 games. This one is the third game, and after the debacle that was the third Gothic game, this is also kind of considered to be the true Gothic 3, or the thing people wanted to see the Gothic 3 be like. But anyway, I could rag on about all this, but I think we have a whole LP to go through, so I think I have more than enough time to talk about it. So instead, we're just going to load a new game.
For longer than humanity remembers, the gods ruled. Humanity served as slaves, but life never remains in balance. Power passed to man, and man banished the gods from the world. But something was released. Something older than man has risen.
Roll credits.
Given their freedom, humanity must fight for survival. Some cling to safety, others fight. It is a time where a man's choices define him.
And here we are, the start of the Risen franchise. Kind of gothic-y, we are a nobody washed up on a completely strange place. We witnessed the guy from the title screen doing something with a titanic creature, but still everything is wrapped in mystery. And the only thing we know is that we had somebody with us, which was not this person, because after all, the name of the guy already implies that he's probably not that alive anymore. But, however, look at that. This person still has a health bar, so I think she might be still alive.
She's still breathing. Are you okay?
Yeah. But I think I drank half the ocean.
Do you remember much about what happened?
Just that strange man from the Inquisition. And the storm. He sailed us straight into it. And then he vanished. The ship must have capsized and we got washed ashore.
Looks like the poor devils over there weren't as lucky as us.
Any idea where we are?
Alright, so he's from the Inquisition. Whatever that is. I mean, you have no idea what it actually means. What it is. I wonder if he's Spanish, though. Because with that vanishing thing, seriously, nobody will ever expect him.
No. Maybe it's another island.
We should get off this beach. This wreckage could draw looters, and they don't like survivors. We're going to need a weapon. Do you think you could have a look around? See if the tide washed up something we can use? A club, a branch. Anything is better than nothing, right? I'll stay here and keep an eye out for other survivors.
Alright, that's a good idea. I'll take this gold coin. That might be an idea. So, let's see. We are looking for a button. In the meantime, one thing that I probably should first explain about this LP, unlike Gothic 2, which was very comprehensive. What the fuck is an egg doing in the middle of the water? Oh well. Which was very comprehensive, the Gothic 2 LP. This Risen LP is gonna be much more, I would say more like a retrospective, because I haven't touched this game since 2009. I checked my last save files, and I only played a little bit to get into the groove of the game again. So it's really more than me just reminiscing, trying to remember. Oh, a bird. Or rather, the Risen equivalent of a scavenger. Also, let's kick the shit out of it. Fuck yeah! Or punch it, rather. It's a sea vulture. Sadly, not this imaginative of a name. Let's see. It doesn't have a weapon either. I think I kinda got caught off track. Maybe something is in the water. Let's see. There's a mussel. Can't use that as a weapon, although our fists seem to do a pretty nice job as well. Let's see. I can also even block. I wonder if it actually works. Whether I can actually block wild creatures again, or how... This is the thing I still have to learn again. Oh yes, this thing also exists. Also, I think he was supposed to spawn in front of me. This is what happens if you get too close to the shore. A giant creature out of the sea comes, gobbles you up, and doesn't kill you. Instead, it just throws you right at the very beginning of the game again. They go back, you forgot something, Jesus Christ. Let's see. Ah, 30 branch, there we go. That is something I probably can use as a weapon. Let's see, 30 branch. And we equipped it. And it's a 200 branch. Nice. And I think in the final step what I realized is that timing is actually kind of an important factor. You could see that if I just clip mat like a madman, I am very slow. But if I have the right timing, you can see you can do the combo much, much quicker. And I'm not... To be honest, I'm not sure if I even knew about that in 2009 when I played through this game. Gold coin. Club. Oh, is that the one-handed? It's probably... Yes, a one-handed weapon. Sadly, it doesn't tell it that it is... Okay, it says sword, it says staff, so yeah, maybe that. And yes. And that's the only thing about the fighting system. It's a little bit more... It's more simplified than Gothic 3, which was the predecessor. Because in Gothic 3, we still had, like, different attack moves. Maybe I'll learn, actually, with skills. I'm not sure. But here you only have mouse one. And the only thing is kind of like Witcher-ish that you have to time your moves so you can get the maximum damage. And I think the third strike of the combo always does more damage than the other two. But anyways, let's actually talk to Sarah. We found a club.
I'm ready. Shall we go?
No time like the present. There must be a path somewhere that leads inland. Let's look for one. Careful. I thought I saw something move in the trees. Get ready. Draw your weapon.
Oh, it's a pity. I just realized she lost her big anime eyes from the intro. Oh, those are actually kind of nice. They kind of reminded me of, kind of like Elizabeth Booker from Cats. Bioshock Infinite. She also had those really big eyes that were almost a little bit ridiculous. But still, I mean, big eyes make characters actually, I guess, sort of compelling. Oh well, I hate another big guy. Drowned person. What, he didn't make it? I didn't realize that. Ooh, that's hunting knife, that's even better. Whoop. And a torch. Coin. So there's another mussel. I think the mussels, you can, let me actually see if I can do it. I think you can open them up and see if there's anything in there.
Yes.
Yes, pearl. Nope. Oh, that was worth it. Well, it's free gold value for 15. Can I also open this? Nope. Clams. Two clams? I don't even know. Oh yeah, one thing I actually forgot to show, which is probably one of the weirdest things at the very beginning of the game, which kind of explains itself after a while, is if you press spacebar, you momentarily defy all gravity. Well, you know, other people will call it a jump button, but seriously, look at this. I can maybe zoom out. This is actually... it's incredibly ridiculous how high he jumps. I mean, he jumps... like... half of his height. And like, in a really slow fashion. There's actually... there's a reason for that, why he jumps that high, and it will be revealed... I think... yeah, there's actually one part where it's actually kind of shown why he jumps so high. But we'll get to that eventually. Also, I might as well quick... is that not a quick save button? Probably have to look up the quick save button afterwards. Let's see, can I block his attack? Yes, I can, but it... is it only... okay, okay. I can block normal attacks as well. So I think the easiest... I kind of forgot about it. I think the strategy I remember is basically block and then just counterattack. I think that used to be the best strategy for this game. I think so. Oh, come on, Piranha Bites. Look at this. That is horrible. But also, I think I quickly need to look up the quick save button. I'm sorry about that. Ah, preparations. Jesus. Let's see. Input. Nach oben, nach unten, nach links. Yes, German. German keyboard. Or rather, Swiss keyboard. Quick save. That is a horrible place to put those. What happened to F5 and F... ah, maybe F5 is like for quick slots or something like that. So I think to settle the mood, let's grab a torch. After all, we're survivors and are trying to find a way to get through. Oh, there's a Wolfie. Let's try and murder Wolfie. Hello, Wolfie. Come here. Okay, as always, just block. Okay, you can't block. Okay, there are... oh yeah, there's some... I guess there's some enemies you can't block. So, the wolves are enemies you can't block. Then again, it makes sense. I mean, I'm holding my shield way upright. So, I would assume that I can't block that rat either. So, yes. Jesus Christ. No, I don't want to die to a rat. Oh, yes. Also, that's a lovely rendered butthole. Come on, you can do it. Hey, come on, I want to see the fight. Ah, yes, now I remember why the... there we go. Punch him in the face. Okay, now I kind of remember why the starting part of the game is actually sometimes a little bit unforgiving. Because there are also barely any healing items, as far as I remember. I think I picked up some plants. Ah, damn, I didn't quick save after the wolf. Alright, let's see if I can just surprise him. There we go. Perfect. Ship's got raw meat, muscle, gold coin.
It must have been attracted by the smell of the bodies. At least we have some meat now. Need a fire or a stove. If I have to eat rat, I'm not eating it raw. And if we can find a pan, we can fry it. Fried meat will help restore our energy, even if it is just rat. We could really do with a few healing plants too. Perhaps there's some that grow around here. Keep a lookout.
Will do, will do. Let's see. Hungry wolf, what does he give you? A tea. A tooth. It's actually one tooth, that's a teeth. Don't lie to me, game. I guess that's just random loot or can be used to craft. Ah, healing orb. How much does it restore? 10 hit points, 5 hit points, apple. Ah, is it like that in like in Gothic 2 where eating apples increases your strength? I think that's actually the case. Also, what? The egg gives me experience? It gave me experience. Also, it's kind of not used to actually getting experience because I'm so used to playing the other Risen 2 and Risen 1 where I get a glory instead. Okay. There we go. Okay, for those, it's just attack for your life. Then hope you kill it first. Ew, that looked disgusting. I wouldn't pick that up if I was the hero, but I'm not the hero. So, I guess let's see. Briefly press him in order to get... oh yeah, that's what the tutorial spouted me as well, but Honestly, I don't know how that works. I didn't get it to work. And I think you're better off just blocking. Hey! Okay, I guess, like, at one, I was, like, briefly stunned so he could actually counter hit, but since he's kind of slow attack, I guess enemies with faster attack could actually abuse that. Also, there is that a secret little path that leads to somewhere nice to loot and booty? Let's see. That is something. That is a healing route. I guess that makes it hard. It's probably the hardest. Yeah, it's like heal plant, heal weed, or whatever. I see. It's, I think, like in the same. Okay, it's not the exact same like in the coffee. It was like plant, herb, root, or something like that. Anyways. Also, yeah, this is also a thing. The problem in this game is also the jump button is jumping around is actually faster than walking. So, most of the game you'll probably see me do this. Although, maybe for like the sake of immersion, I guess. Oh, another sturdy branch. I guess I'll try to avoid it a little bit. Because, I mean, it's kind of annoying to see me jump around. Ooh, are those?
This cave seems a little eerie. Let's find a different way, please. This doesn't feel right.
Oh, stop being a big... Oh, yes! I completely forgot! Those are gnomes, and gnomes are actually just normal hostile enemies in the... And they're so fucking adorable, look at them! I forgot that they're actually just normal hostile enemies in the first game. That guy just took it like a champ. Oh, wow. Ah, they're too adorable to murder, but I have to. I'm so sorry. I also have a pretty fast attack rate, I just realized. Oops. I have to say, the fighting game is actually better than I used to. Oh, actually, the Risen fighting system was not that bad. Also, I should stop trying to get the first strike instead of just counter hit. Oh, I'm so sorry, gnome. Man, Jafar would be really mad at me. He would probably go, fuck no. I don't even know if anybody will get that reference, because that's... Oh, that's a sickle. I was about to say, is that a panda that is halfway buried in the ground? But I think it was the other guy's weapon. And I think in gothic fashion, the... sickle is probably an inferior weapon to my knife. It's probably like 7 damage or so. Oh, it's 10 damage. It got buffed in the other games. Ah, also blade damage, blunt weapon. Oh, there's actually a difference. That's good to know, so I guess there is still the... See, I don't think I don't have a frying pan.
I need a frying pan.
Yes, I don't have a frying pan. So I guess I'm just gonna eat something else, like... Where's grilled meat? Om nom nom. Oh, my torch ran. I was about to say that just eating meat disabled my torch, because that would be kind of stupid. It's also a little bit weird because in Gothic 3 you could actually handle a weapon and a torch at the same time. Oh. Sadly, I can't abuse them during the attack animation. Ah, Jesus. Okay, I really have to counterattack quickly because they actually have quick. Ow, Jesus. Damn. Alright. Oh yeah, I'm playing, by the way, on hard difficulty. So at least I can justify that, me dying at the very beginning a couple of times. But it's not that bad. I hope. And okay, this is also, I think, an aspect that I kind of didn't notice when first playing here. There's actually a different... On the other hand, my two playthroughs I did in Risen 1 were first time archer, second time mage. So basically I never bothered with melee weapons at all. God damn it. Really have to attack really quick, otherwise they... Come on, attack me. Okay, I still have to like work on the combo a little bit, but... Turnip. Might as well eat that turnip offers. So why didn't you want to go in a Ziri cave? It's just a couple of gnomes. Okay, they kicked my ass, but still. Mana mushroom? Which I guess restores mana. Duh. See, yep. rooms. Also, wait, didn't I pick up Grog? Does that maybe restore health, or is that just in the second game? Yeah, here it's still, it does in gothic fashion restore your mana, and this, from the second game on, it restores your health, or I mean blood. Weirdly enough name. But yes, this is going to be kind of a weird experience after all, I'm currently playing Risen 3, and maybe there will be soon a revival of Gothic 3, Steam, so this is going to be like playing three Piranha Bytes game at the same time. I guess it's going to be kind of interesting to see like the different things blend together, but at the same time it could probably also be kind of annoying to constantly get used to the other mechanics. Ooh, purse. Do I have to open it? Yes, Fint purse isn't weigh much. Oh, 25 gold. Also, one thing I always find kind of weird is, well, I could use the branch as a weapon, but I can't use a bone as a weapon. Okay, I guess. I guess it depends what kind of branch it is. I mean, it says, does it say? Oh, okay. Moldy old bones. I guess that thing will probably break pretty easily. Skeleton. Good, well done, skeleton. That's for all the Dark Souls homies. Bolt and a rusty sword, which is, it's a miracle it doesn't fall apart, and it's worse. It's as good as a branch also. That's also kind of for the Dark Souls homies, I guess.
Wish I knew about prospecting.
I don't know about that. So let's just move on. Do I have some healing items? I could probably, let's eat an apple. Eat a turnip. Wow, that restores like no health whatsoever. Okay, let's take an healing herb. Om nom 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 nom. Delicious. And let's see what awaits us.
Do you see those torches? There must be people nearby. Do you think we should head for where the torches are?
Makes sense. Well, let's quickly see. I guess this leads back to the beginning. To the very beginning. I think this is like the other path I didn't take. Almost has to be. Yeah, I think this was the crossroads. This is where I found the dead pirate captain. So yes, we are making progress. So let's jump up the hill. Oh yeah, this is also beautiful. There's also other thing that I guess kind of fixed in the other games, because if you can jump up the hill, and also I think the camera doesn't like it particularly. Yeah. Ah, the joys. Because the camera... Okay, stop exploiting the game. Jesus. And another wolf. That means no blocking allowed. Yeah, first strike does a lot more damage. Also, is there... like a... can I like... oh yeah. Oh, the... It does have a sidestep move like the... like in the other games, Risen games. And it's even sensible! It's not like in Risen 2 or Risen 3 where he jumps across the whole island with one single dodge roll. Seriously. This is one thing I never understood about... especially this is even more confusing when they actually got it right in like Risen 1, that they fucked it up in Risen 2 and Risen 3. Especially since at least in Risen 3, it has no cooldown whatsoever, and here it has at least a little cooldown. And in Risen 2, you can just roll around at the speed of sound. But luckily don't make horrible games about weird furry kind of creatures. Alright. There is another sting rat, and I kind of afraid of them. Not because they have a lovely rendered butthole, but instead because they can kind of kick my ass. But there we go. I am a master fighter already. Step aside, world. Oh, that was a healing potion, actually. Or a healing vial, I guess. Right. Hey, there's a house. I wonder if there's anyone home. At least fire's burning. It doesn't really look...
look, it's a house. Looks abandoned. I wonder what happened here.
Something must have driven the occupants away.
Whatever it was, it's certainly not warming me to this place.
Let's take a look around. We might find something useful.
You have a look inside, and I'll keep a watch out here. I'll call if any more of those rats turn up.
You are a real you're really asset to this group. Oh, raw meat. Bench. Let's see. Investigate the abandoned house.
Now who could teach me to pick locks? Now who could teach me to pick locks?
You could at least try it. Let's see, a broom. Certainly useful in our travels. Ah, there's a key. Quest success, hooray. This is one thing they already started. Oh, they didn't already start with it in the third game, that they get like the pettiest quest successes. Coin, healing potion, water, milk. I've got milk! Oh, is that a reference to the Got Milk ad? I guess so. Ah, frying pan. That means we can cook our meat. Yes, thank you. I looted a chest in an abandoned house, I'm so good. And I guess, let's see, how is the rest of this? Is this like old... Yeah. Typical gothic style. Morning, noon... dawn or midnight. Ooh, mint. So we can cook lovely rabbit stew with mint. Nom 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 nom. Delicious. Is that... That is a wolf. That's actually... Does that thing look bigger? Or is it just a normal wolf? I know it's a... I would say hungry wolf is probably just the implication that it's like a weak sort of wolf. It's basically like the young scavenger or young mole rat or young field raider of the other games. And hungry wolf probably means like, oh, he's so starved, he's so weak. Also, that is the tutorial area. I think that, this is the cave entrance right below there. So, no business here. Let's hover over this log and walk backwards, I suppose. There's nothing here. Maybe there's something... Ah, yes, water barrels. I think for restoring health, but I think the problem is in this game... Yes. They only restore a fraction of health. And that's sort of annoying because you can see how long the animation takes. And they actually did that better in Risen 3, because in Risen 3, if you drink from the barrel, it has like... I think it started in the second game with that you have like provisions that like gradually restore health just over time. And drinking from the water barrel just fully heals you, but it's only like gradually restored. Health. Oh, there's a camp again. Let's see. Basic chest. What do you have to offer me, basic chest? Coin, mana potion. Well, I probably won't be needing that anytime soon. Cutting wood and pixie hat. Dexterity. Oh, okay, that's... That is the goblin berries of Risen. It's always great if you can, like, see the... the variables. I mean, it's the same with like Dark Souls and Bloodborne, which also had like so many completely similar items but just renamed, so you basically spent the game figuring out, basically seeing which item is which, the equivalent of that in the other game. So let's see. There's a moldy tree. So I guess we go to Saren, say we successfully found a frying pan.
Doesn't look like there's been anyone in this house for a while. All I found was a locked chest.
Unless you have the key or a talent for picking locks, it's going to stay locked.
Oh, gee golly.
I've opened the chest.
Find anything useful?
Just a frying pan. Everything else is junk.
Oh well, at least you can fry up that meat. I could do with a little fried meat right now. You're probably starving too. And we can pretend it's venison.
You told me that you're a good cook. Now I have to suddenly fry meat. Jeez. Alright, let's fry. Let's see if we can do a fried herring, which gives... hit points and mana. I don't know how a fish can do that. You're doing great, lad. Good. Okay, let's fry meat because that actually restores a decent amount of health. And luckily, like, I think Gothic 3 also had the thing that you can mass do that.
Looks good.
Hooray, fried meat, a chicken drumstick.
This smells good.
Alright. And I mean, basically, what did we kill? Wolf could be almost like venison, could taste like venison. Also, Let's actually put some stuff in our quick slots. Might as well. There we go. And for top that around. There we go. For bigger things. Anyways, I think this is a pretty good stopping point. I think next time we're going to go further this path. Or wait a minute. Do you want some meat?
Here's your fried meat.
At least if you don't think about where it came from. Hey, that's not bad.
Well, I'm a good cow. I'm a good cook. Thank you very much.
We should head further inland.
You go on. I really need to rest. That storm took it out of me. I feel exhausted. I'm going to stay here for a while.
Okay. I'll come back and get you when I know a bit more about this place.
Don't worry about me. Be careful out there. I saw a path to the north. Looked like it led further inland. Maybe there's a village or something up there.
There we go. This is a better stopping point. Chapter 1, The Forbidden Island. Very well. So, next episode, we're going to take the path further inland. Also, Sarah, don't you prefer, there's a bed inside there you could sleep in. You don't have to sit in the dirt, but whatever floats your boat, girl. Anyways, next episode, we're going to head further inland and see if we can maybe also find someone local to this island. Up to this point, je suis Gorshmoid.neuf, and au revoir.